Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to install Paperless-NGX using Docker. Paperless is an open source document management system. It is designed to make converting your physical documents into a searchable online archive as simple as possible. It achieves this by providing a place where you can easily upload images or scans of your documents. Paperless then uses optical character recognition so that it can understand the text on your pages. This makes it much easier to deal with physical documents as it becomes something that you can easily search through a very easy to use web interface. On top of supporting physical scans of documents, Paperless can also process your digital documents. It has support for a variety of formats including PDF, as well as the various Office formats including LibreOffice. With your documents uploaded, Paperless can utilize machine learning to understand and automatically categorize your documents. If this all sounds interesting to you, be sure to continue on with this video to learn how you can easily set it up on your system using a Docker container. We are doing this tutorial on Ubuntu, but this tutorial should work fine on most other Linux-based operating systems. To get started with setting up Paperless-NGX, open up the terminal on your Linux machine. Our first step is to ensure the kel and wget packages are installed in your system. On any Debian-based system, you can install these by typing sudo space apt space install space kel space wget space hyphen y and then pressing enter. You'll probably be prompted to enter your password for your superuser. Once installed, we can use kel to install Docker by typing kel space hyphen s capital L space https colon forward slash get.docker.com space pipe symbol space sh and then press enter. This command will grab the official Docker install script and run it directly. Once Docker is installed, we'll want to add our current user to the Docker group. We can achieve this by typing in sudo space usermod space hyphen a capital G space docker space dollar sign symbol and then user all in uppercase. For this user change to properly be read in by the rest of your system, we'll want to reboot it by typing in sudo space reboot. Now that we have Docker installed onto our system, we can move on to setting up the Paperless-NGX Docker container. The first part of this process is to create a directory where we will store both the Docker Compose file for Paperless as well as its ingest and storage folders. You can create this directory by typing in sudo mkdir space hyphen p space slash opt slash stacks slash paperless hyphen ngx and then press enter. Once a directory has been created, you'll want to change into it by typing in cd slash opt slash stacks slash paperless hyphen ngx. Now that we're in this new directory, we use the wget tool to download a template for the Docker Compose file. We can do this by typing in sudo space wget space https colon forward slash git.pymylifeup.com slash compose slash paperless hyphen ngx slash compose.yaml and then press enter. With the compose file now saved, we now need to grab the environment file that will be ready to load in the settings for Paperless-NGX. We can download this by typing in sudo space wget space https colon forward slash git.pymylifeup.com slash compose slash paperless hyphen ngx slash dot env. Before we can begin to edit this configuration file, we'll need to get the ID of your current user. This is important for ensuring that Paperless-NGX uses the correct user for the files it imports and saves. You can get this ID by typing in ID space hyphen U and then pressing enter. In our case, you can see that our user ID is 1000. Now that we know your user's ID, we can now open the .env file for editing by typing in sudo space nano space .env and then pressing enter. The first thing you'll want to do within this file is replace the user ID placeholder with the ID that you just retrieved. In our case, we'll be setting this to 1000. Next, if you want your paperless installation to be accessible outside of your home network, you'll likely want to set a URL. For example, if we wanted this available on paperless.pymylifeup.com, we would replace this with https://paperless.pymylifeup.com. One important thing to note here is that Paperless-NGX does not support HTTPS. For this to actually work, we would need to set up a reverse proxy in front that provides the SSL functionality. If you don't plan on this being accessible outside of your home network, simply delete this line. The next thing we'll want to do is set the secret key for Paperless. This is super important as it's what helps secure your installation. Replace the secret key placeholder with a random jumble of letters and numbers. It doesn't have to be anything you can remember, as only the software itself needs to know this key. A next step is set the time zone that Paperless-NGX will use within its Docker container. To do this, you'll want to place the time zone placeholder with a valid TZ identifier. If you don't know yours, we'll leave a link in the description below where you can easily find it. For example, in our case, we would use Australia/Hobart. The next environment variable that we'll want to set is the one that controls the default OCR language. You'll want to set this to the code that represents the language for what most of your documents will be in. For example, if we were using English, we would use ENG. We will leave a link to a website where you can see the codes that you can use for this value. Out of the box, the Paperless-NGX Docker container only contains support for 5 different languages. The first is English, which you can specify using ENG. The second is German, which you would set using DEU. And then Italian, which is ITA, and then SPA for Spanish, and finally FRA for French. While Paperless-NGX only contains support for these 5 languages out of the box, it can support a huge amount more. And that is where a final option comes into play. Using this option, you can control what languages are available to Paperless. We'll leave a link to where you can find a list of the supported languages in the description below. For example, if we wanted to add the support for Dutch, we would replace this placeholder with NLD. And if we wanted to add support for an additional language, we'd add a space and then type in another code such as GPAN for Japanese. Now, if you don't need any additional languages, you can simply remove this line. At this point, you have finished configuring the Paperless-NGX Docker container and can now quit and save by pressing Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then Enter. Everything is now in place, and we can start up Paperless-NGX by typing in docker compose up and then hyphen D. The hyphen D option tells Docker to run in the background once it has started up the container. If you ever run into errors with starting the container, removing this option should allow you to see the logs being produced by your containers easily. At this point, you have now got Paperless-NGX up and running. To access its web interface, you will need to know the IP address of your machine. If you don't know, you can easily get it by typing in hostname space hyphen capital I and then pressing enter. In our case, you can see our machine's local IP address is 192.168.0.212. Now, open up your favorite web browser and go to http followed by your IP address, which in our case is 192.168.212, and then a colon symbol, and then the port 8000, and then press enter. The first time you load up Paperless, it will ask you to create your admin account. Type in a username and a password, and then click the sign up button. You can also optionally send email, but this is not required to use Paperless-NGX. At this point, you have successfully set up Paperless-NGX using a Docker container. You can now begin to upload your documents and learn how to use Paperless. If you're just beginning, you can always click the Start the Tour button, which will take you through how Paperless is meant to work and explain itself. If you found this guide on installing Paperless-NGX using Docker to be helpful, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.